planning, the second-level evaluator's role. This tutorial will review the role of the second-level evaluator in the performance planning process. The State Civil Service Rules outlines the responsibilities of the second-level evaluator in the performance management system. The second-level evaluator must concur with and approve the performance planning form and the performance evaluation form prepared by the evaluating supervisor. When you have a form to review, it will appear on your dashboard in the For You Today section. Click to open the form. Or you can go to the Home menu and click on Performance. The form will appear in your In Progress inbox. Click on the form to open it. Review the goals created for the employee. Note, while the system requires a minimum of 3 goals for the form to be routed, it does not analyze the goal category. You must manually check the goals to ensure that there are at least 2 performance-based goals and 1 behavior-based goal in the planning. When reviewing goals, consider these questions as well. Do the goals for this employee align with organizational goals? Do the goals for this employee align with the employee's position description? Are the goals for this employee SMART? Specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound? If you do not agree with the goals created, you may send this form back to the evaluating supervisor for revision. The system does not allow you to explain why you are not approving the form. Therefore, you will need to reach out to the evaluating supervisor to discuss your required revisions. If you do not approve the planning form, click Save and Send to Evaluating Supervisor. The next screen asks you to confirm your selection. If you do approve of the planning, click Save and Send to Planning Acknowledgement. Confirm your selection or cancel and return to form. Once you approve the performance management planning form, multiple actions occur. First, the state of the goal plan changes to approved, which means goals cannot be added, edited, or deleted. Second, the form is sent to the supervisor and the employee simultaneously. And that covers the role of the second-level evaluator in the planning process. Thanks for watching.